This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video. Hey guys, Jannik here for CineCam.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday. As you all know, we have an extra video on Sunday called Cine Battle. Here Jordi and I battle each other to determine who the best filmmaker is. And of course you all know that Team Blue is the best, which is me. But sometimes I let Jordi win, so he won't be sad. An example for this is the Cine Battle where we had to make the interface from Iron Man within 1 hour. A super fun battle, but I let Jordi win that one. No, let's be honest, my end result wasn't that good. So I want to redeem myself by making a super realistic Iron Man hood and set the score straight. Also, another reason why we are making this effect is that you guys asked for it like crazy after the Cine Battle. So we had to do it. Now for the hood effect, you can make it as simple as you want. Let me take my Pip-Boy to show you. Like you can see here, if you don't have any moving objects, you don't need to do anything special. I'll show you in After Effects. In After Effects, you just place your HUD asset into a composition and change the blending mode to Add. The next thing you now do is make the layer 3D and move it to the wanted place. And that's really it for a simple HUD effect. But for the Iron Man HUD, we are going to go a step further to make it really cool. And what do you need for this cool effect? Well, the first thing you need is a shot of your actor. And this is going to be shot on a tripod on eye level. You can also go quite close to the actor with your camera. For the movement of the actor, you want it minimal. You have to imagine that your head is stuck in a helm so you can't move around a lot. To make it yourself easier, you can use reference points next to the camera. This will give the actor something real to look at and will also make sure that he doesn't move too far with his head. Now the next important thing is the lighting, but I think Jordi wants to explain that for you guys.
Exactly, and your main source of light is going to be that of the HUD itself. And we are going to use a very small lighting for that. This one right here is the brand new Aperture MC. And what's really cool about it is that it is an RGB light. You get a bunch of presets, as you can see this cop car, or you can also just go for plain white or whatever you'd like. And what you want to do is hold this from below of your subject. And you kind of want to like resemble the movements of the HUD. So whenever you have an element coming in, an animation, you want to move your lighting in as we can see right here. Now you can also like let this light flicker or whatever you want. Now if you don't have one of these lights, which you can by the way find the link to in the description below, you can also use your mobile phone and just use your flashlight for that. I'm pretty sure that there are a bunch of apps that allows you to let the light flicker or whatever. So that's gonna be your main lighting source. Then your second lighting is gonna be a soft light. And I'm gonna use this one right here, which is the Aperture 120D with a softbox over it, which is gonna stand behind the camera like so. And I'm also going to dim this because the brightest light source should that be of the HUD, which is your small LED panel, not the cop car, but this one right here coming from below. And that's kind of it for the lighting. The final thing that you want to pay attention to is that you're filming this in a dark room, or at least have a black, dark background. So we're going to shut off all of the lights in here and close the dome so that we have that. And then we've got a perfect setup for the Iron Man HUD effect. All right, Jannik, back to you.
Thank you for that, Jordi. But now last but not least, the HUD or the interface assets. Well, you can find those over the internet or make them yourself. But we got our assets from our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. After searching for 10 minutes, I already had like 20 assets and an After Effects project file with over 200 pre-made interface elements, which is quite insane if you ask me. Storyblocks Video, their library is so vast and easy to use, it's almost too good to be true. And with their one fixed price per year, it becomes even better. That's why Storyblocks Video is our go-to site for video assets. And it's also why I recommend Storyblocks Video to anyone in the film business. If you want to start downloading right away, go to the first link in the description below. Now that we have all the assets we need for this effect, let's jump into After Effects. In After Effects, we are going to start by placing the face shot into a composition. Then we are going to mask out the face. We do this to make the background completely black like in the movie. Next, we are going to track the mask so that it follows the small movements of the actor. Right click on the mask and track the mask. Now in the tracker panel, choose the face tracking outline option. Start the tracking and if needed, you can always stop the tracking and adjust it manually. After the tracking is done, feather the mask a bunch. Next, we are going to make the eyes a little bit brighter to give them a pop. Just duplicate the layer and remove the mask. Then add the Lemaitre effect to the new layer and with the exposure slider, make the shot brighter. Now create a new mask in the shape of glasses and feather them. This will make the eyes a lot brighter, something they also do in the real movie. For the tracking of the face, we are going to use the 3D camera tracking. But first you need to pre-comp the two layers and move all attributes into a new composition. Then you can click on the track camera option in the tracker panel and let After Effects do its thing. Once done, look for some points on Jill's face. Here you can right click and choose the option Set Ground Plane and Origin. With doing this, we tell After Effects that this is the plane we want to place elements on. The last step of the tracking is to create a camera, which you can do in the effects controls. Next, we are going to add the interface elements. Like I said before, the ones we use are all found on Storyblocks video. Now pick one you really like and drag them into the composition. The first thing you now can do is change the blending mode of the element to Add. Of course, the next step is to make the layer 3D by enabling this checkbox. After Effects will now place the layer on the origin you just set, but will also scale and rotate it, so let's adjust that. Next, we want to place it better in the 3D space, and this you can do with the anchor point properties. So adjust them until the element sits completely in place. A tip I can give you is to flip your asset if it contains some text. It needs to be in the right reading direction for the actor and not the viewer. This is already a good starting base for the HUD. But of course, we are going to make it even cooler. The first thing you can do is add a glow to the element, and if you want, you can also adjust the settings to your likings. The next step we are doing really finishes the effect. We are going to give the elements a 3D look. Select your element and pre-compose it. This time select the option Leave all attributes into the composition. Now go into the new composition and select the element. You can already make the element 3D and set the blending mode to Add. With the masking tool, create a round mask around a part of the element. This can be whatever you want. It can also be a square or a custom shape, depending on your asset. Now once you make your mask, set it to subtract to cut everything inside. Next, we are going to duplicate the layer and set the mask back to Add. This will again show everything inside the mask. Then move the layer forward on the Z axis. To have a better look on this, you can change your view to custom view in this tab. Then with the Orbit Camera tool, you can now change your viewing perspective. And now you can see that you already have a 3D look. This step you can repeat multiple times. First you create a smaller second mask on the duplicate and set it to subtract. This will leave you with a small portion of the element. Next again, duplicate the layer and keep making the mask smaller, so you end up with smaller elements each time. Also move them forward on the Z axis to get that 3D feeling. Now when you go back to your original composition, the last thing you now need to do is check the rasterize option and boom, your effect is done. Now you can keep on adding elements as much as you want.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Jarvis. What's on my schedule for today?
You are needed for Cinebattle, sir.
Cinecom, time to work for a living.
Shorty? The new guy is kinda weird.
Yeah.
And Jill, get back to work.
Uh-oh. Jarvis, turn off.
And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks Video, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Didn't even say who is that? Come on, man. Come. Wat me even in een element komen, ik pak me niet serieus, hè.
Maar kom.